What's up? I'm OBG for TastingSkills.com. Welcome back to another video. All right, so today I have High West Whiskey. Now I have two of them. I have the Double Rye here, which is a barrel select. It's actually cast finished in peated whiskey. Then, of course, I have their Rendezvous. This is just a staple when it comes to their line of whiskeys. Now, let's talk a little bit about High West. High West has been around since 2005, if I'm not mistaken. They do have a small pot still, but the big story here is that they built a brand off MGP whiskey. Now, what is MGP? Well, MGPI, as is known, is one of the biggest distilleries that we have in the country. Now, they do make whiskey and they just sell it to people that bottle it under their own brand. Now, High West was bought by Constellation Brand in 2016 for a whopping $160 million. Now, these two whiskeys that we have here are MGP ingredients whiskeys. Now, these are both ryes. Let's take a look at the technicals of these two different whiskey. And we're going to start, of course, with the High West Rendezvous. This is a blend of straight rye whiskey. This has an ABV of 46 or a proof of 92. And this retails for $70. Then we have the one that I have in my hand, which is the High West Double Rye. Now, this is a blend of straight rye whiskey. This is finished in a Scotch cask whiskey for a minimum of 9 months. And the ABV on here is 49.8. or the proof is 98.6. Now, this also retails for $70. Now, this is a barrel selection from Corey's Fine Wine and Spirits that's in Las Vegas, actually in Henderson. That's my local store. He's a friend. I've reviewed other brands that he's personally picked, but remember that barrel picks, just like High West, you can find in your local liquor store. So if you just find a small liquor store or a big one, they usually have their own picks so that you can enjoy something different. Now, when we look at the packaging of this, everybody loves these little bubbles in the glass. I'm personally not a fan. I do love the mold. They have their own mold when it comes to their own bottle. The cork looks like it's semi synthetic here, or it's a composite, I would say, with a wooden top. Packaging wise, it's good. It's been around for a while. They really haven't updated it in a long time, since I think when they first started, but this is still pretty good. All right, so let's take a look at the tasting notes and figure out if they are worth the money. But before that, do you want to taste like a pro? Head over to tastingskills.com, put your name and email into the magical yellow box, and I will send you my free 17-page guide to the fundamentals of tasting. But not only that, if you want to get a sober hat or a sober t-shirt, well, when you're at checkout at tastingskills.com, just put the promo code IMOBG and shipping will be free because it's on me. All right, now let's jump into the tasting notes of the Rendezvous and of this Double Rye Scotch cask finish. On the color, you get this orange, gold, amber. On the nose, high rye nose that has an intense American oak that is highly charred in smoke, vanilla, caramel, toffee, oranges, cherry, honey. This is eye on the alcohol side. Yes, you do get some hints of the cinnamon, some cedar, some tobacco, and it is expensive. On the mouthfeel, clean, crisp burn that delivers spicy oak tannins that work the mouth into a cutting acidity that eventually turns sweet. The caramel, the vanilla, and the fruit notes are good, but the oak tannins are what drives this rye whiskey. And the finish is spicy into a medium to long length. Now, this had a really high burn. I thought that would be a little sweeter for it being a rye, first of all. Second of all, it had a lot of layers. The nose was really pretty. The mouthfeel wasn't really equal to the actual nose. I did enjoy the nose, but the mouthfeel had a little high burn for me. The wood tannins were solid. I mean, overall, this was pretty good. I mean, am I in love with it? Not really, but again, this is a big player in the market. This is a brand that you need to know. This is a brand that you need to taste. All right, let's move on to the other one, which is the Corey's Fine Wine and Spirits Barrel Pick. On the color, deep gold with amber notes. On the nose, the peat is there in all of its beauty. Since this is aged in a Scotch barrel, you get right away the iodine, the medicinal cabinet, the smokiness that is just beautiful. And this could easily confuse anyone in a blind tasting. On the mouthfeel, you get a spicy dill, tarragon, marjoram that delivers some serious peated smoke. It is just delicious. Once you get past it, you fall into some spicy wood tannins from the barrel that just keeps on giving as the acidity just drives a lot of this whiskey. And once again, this isn't on the sweeter side. It just keeps on giving green notes like actual peat itself and some vegetable chlorophyll that is really good. This is an imposter as it feels like a real scotch from the Islay region. This High West double rye peat cast finish was delicious. But again, I'm a sucker for peat. So anything that gets peat, I love. That's just my palate. That's my preference. But if you're not into peated whiskey, then this is probably not for you. Overall, this delivered. It was pretty good. I'm impressed. But again, this it's because of the actual barrel finish that they put in here. This is a good barrel pick. I mean, this is almost 100 proof. This was interesting and really good at the same time. All right, let's do a recap of what you should buy or pass, or if you should collect any of those. We're gonna start, of course, with the High West Rendezvous. This was a pass for me. For $70, you could be drinking a lot of crazy whiskey out there, especially in the rye category. You could be drinking Sazerac for $30, or you can even do a Renton House bottled in bond for around $20. So unfortunately, this is a pass. Then we have the Double Rye Corey's Fine Wine and Spirits Barrel Pick. Now this was a buy for me. And if you can find some of it in your own market, unless you live in Las Vegas, then this would be a buy because cast finish on here was amazing. The other thing though is that this is $70. This is a lot of money for rye, especially American rye. Now, I'm not trying to trash it, but I'm just saying, if this would not be peated cast finish, then this would be an absolute pass. All right, that's gonna do it for me. I'm OBG for tastingskills.com. Please remember to smash that like button and go down there and please click the subscribe button. Otherwise, my friend, please remember, stay sober. Peace.